So this is
one of the recording setup used for recording all meetups and events. So usually for recording there are three elements that we will record. One would be the video of the speaker. The next would be the screen capture of his presentation. And then the third thing would be the audio. Right, so we're quite trying to get good quality audio. So, and we use a computer, a laptop, a Windows laptop as the hub to basically collect all these three sources and mix them together in software. There's a software called OBS, Open Broadcaster Software, which we use to mix the video, the screen capture, as well as the audio together into one video file. So it's pre-mixed picture in picture and as one MP4 file that you can just use and upload straight away. So for the video recording, we use a webcam. So a simple webcam, Logitech webcam like this, which we mount on the tripod. And on the tripod, basically we put it right close to the front. This thing is a fixed lens, there's no zoom. So the only way to zoom is to move the tripod itself, right? So just move it close to the speaker, not too close that you see it only his face, but at least see the upper torso and him gesticulating. So that's usually how we...
Like this,
yes. Yeah, so that's the usual thing. For the audio, we use a condenser microphone like this. And we have a USB sound card that can interface with the condenser microphone. Condenser microphone is a little bit special. It needs to be charged, so there needs to be power sent to it. So this sound card is called the Blue Icicle. It's meant to help you with that. So it sends the power to this guy, charges it, and then you can pick up the audio from it. So the audio pickup from this guy is pretty good. This is a cheap microphone, it's about $30 on Lazada. And the microphone diaphragm is over here. So basically this is the part, right? So this is the part that has to face the speaker, right? So this part is the one that has to face the speaker. Later on when we set it up, right?
What does the other side look like?
So we know the other side, just, there's no label there.
So the only way you know is if you look carefully. No, not even. It's just like, it's the side of the label.
Just the label.
Okay. The label is what tells us.
Right. When you look,
it's a receiver.
Yeah, you look inside the grill, you'll see the receiver there. Okay. So, yeah. So, this is usually mounted on a small little microphone stand like this and put on the tabletop. The screen capture tool is used, it's done with it's a game capture tool.
Do you feel comfortable doing that? Thank you.
Anything.
So the screen capture tool is done with a game capture thing called AverMedia. AverMedia Live Gaming Corp all the world. It's used traditionally used by gamers to record their PS2 or Xbox gaming and all that stuff. But we're using it to capture the HDMI input, and this sends a video stream through the USB, and then the software will capture this up, right? And to be able to send capture signal, that's alright, from the speaker's laptop, we usually use a splitter. So from the presenter's laptop, there's a HDMI out to this input. And there are two outputs. One goes to the projector, the other one goes to your screen recording tool, which is the AverMedia. Right, so the output, usually output one goes to the projector, output two is the one that you send to the AverMedia Live Gaming Portable, which has the input channel here.
Okay.
It's kind of special because this guy does some weird magic to the HDMI signal.
That kind of copy protection, right?
Yes. Yeah. So it has a special...
Allegedly
special thingy, yes. So what you see on this table is all the equipment kind of laid out. So we have a laptop, there's an extension cable. There's an extension cable for USB, so it's meant for the webcam. So you can put your laptop slightly further away from the speaker, right? Your laptop can be slightly further away from the speaker.
And it's got a little power cord here too.
Yeah, because it's so long.
This thing is charged. It sends power through the thing. But in case it's not enough, you can actually plug in the another power adapter to it.
Is that what this is?
No,
that's a different one.
This is meant for the.
So we don't have a power adapter to plug into this?
No, we don't.
Okay, that's
probably
what I was
done later.
Yeah. All right.
So just helped. Yeah. So that's so at Neo, or rather at the Pivotal, you can actually set up the wire to plug directly to the presenter's laptop. Or the other way which we can do it is to use the Apple TV. So as long as the presenter does an AirPlay to the Apple TV, we can actually hijack the signal coming out from Apple TV.
Makes sense.
There'll be one way to do it wirelessly, so they don't have to have cables across the table.
Cool.
Yeah. So I'll now try to set it up for you guys.
And we could do it with Chromecast too, right? We just plug the Chromecast into the thing.
Yeah, of course we have a switcher there, so you just switch it to correct.
Okay.
You know, make sure you hijack the output from there.
Oh, just take the switcher's output. Yeah, that makes more sense.
Yeah, just take the switcher's output and that should be fine.
Okay.
Right, so the switcher's output goes into this guy, and then you have one that goes to the projector, the other one that goes to our screen capture too.
So out 1 and 2 are basically the same though, right?
Yes, out 1 and 2 are basically the same, Okay, so let's try and set this up. We can set up the pointers. So this thing basically screws it into the microphone, to this guy. And open up the legs. This thing, this time, this.
Either way,
both ways. Yeah, it goes to the
same.
Yeah, same. Right. So, and this guy just slips in to
the top.
So make sure it the label is facing the speaker.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So basically, you can just point it towards the speaker like this.
If you want to avoid too much pop, you can turn this to 45 degrees away from the speaker.
Or you can use a
and the pop screen as well.
Yeah. So.
But this will stop heavy peas.
Here you have the. So this thing is using XLR cable. You can plug this into the bottom. So this part, there's a little groove there and it fits right in.
Pops into the clip.
You hear a clip sound? Yes. That's great. Yeah. And then you just lay it out. And this one has a USB connector as well. Close to your laptop. Okay? So since the presenter is going to be sitting here, usually you find out where the presenter will stand or sit. So it's going to be around here. The microphone placement should be around this area. As for the laptop, since all the connectors are on that side, I think it's best for a laptop over there. And can screw the webcam into it. So one thing to note, try to connect everything up first before you turn on the power on the computer. From past experience, that seems to be the best way to make sure things will connect properly. Yeah. Okay. So webcam. If the webcam is close enough to your laptop, you don't need to actually use the extension cable. Right? You can just kind of pull it towards your laptop. I guess I'm not sure where to put that later, but this is close enough for us. So there are three USB ports on this laptop. So there's 1, 2, 3. So can you see the 1, 2, 3? This and the sound card. This one's with the white cable. So yeah, that can go into the back. Right, so the left one will be basically for the screen capture too. So you can pass me that. Yeah. And the cable. So all these USB cables are actually color coded. So you have a green color label for this, so you know that this is the appropriate one for that. As well as for the power, for the screen capture too, the HDMI splitter, there's also a red color label so you won't get confused, I hope. Let's see. So last thing, so we have the webcam connected, we have the microphone connected, the this guy is connected to the PC now. So the last thing we set up is the HDMI splitter and that cable. Okay. So the splitter is here. So we'll basically hijack the output. Yeah. So you can first connect the power to this guy. You can just plug it into there. I think it should be enough slack, I hope. Otherwise, just drag it back a little bit. Okay, right. So, as I said, input from the output. Where's the output?
This one, right?
Yeah, okay, cool. So, output to...
Just take it out of the wall, yeah.
You can take it out of the wall, or I can just take this out, right? Take this out.
If you have a different cord, oh yeah.
Yeah, so then this goes to output one. And now we'll need one cable.
But then we'll need to put this in here.
Nope.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we should be able to use this.
Got it.
Output.
Okay.
One. And this.
Yeah, same.
You could use a shorter one. There's not short one on the cable.
Does the length make a difference?
Shouldn't.
Okay.
Yeah, so we use a short one from here. I'll put one, two.
So as long as you have one out going into the splitter's input,
and
you're going to take one of the splitter's outputs back to our presenting device, and then the other output is going to go into your screen recording red box.
So this is the long one. So yeah, it's cool. Okay. It's going to be 12. Yeah, this goes to the AVA media. So that should be good enough for...
Can I ask a technical question?
Sure.
Why do we need this box? Why can't you just plug directly into the computer? What is this red box doing that the computer can't do?
The computer doesn't have a HDMI input. It only has HDMI out.
Got it.
So this is meant to take in HDMI input, convert it into a webcam signal.
Got it.
And then we can see it in the software later on.
Thank you. Yeah.
Why not use QuickTime screen recording or equivalent?
That would require the presenter to install some software or for him to use his own laptop for that. So
this is just a hardware solution for that?
It's a hardware solution for that, yes, that's correct. And basically, I want to be able to compose the video, the picture in picture, and put it together with the video of the presenter together in one screen. So in the past, I'll have to record this separately as three different files, go home, do post-production.
Does it give you picture-in-picture?
The software I will show you later has that configured. The software, okay. So let's check all our connections. We have the webcam, it's connected right now. The microphone, it's connected right now. The AV media is also connected, and the splitter is set up. Let's get this power. This is all powered.
I guess the other thing about the AV is that any software solution is going to affect your performance of the software running. So if it's high performance software, then this is obviously the way. So
I
think gamers will highlight pad.
So with all the connectors set up, so you can start the computer now. So that's essentially it. I'll show you the software now.
Playing, it's draining my battery.
Okay, right, so part two.
Hey.
So the software time. So once the laptop is up, there's a password. Password is just a pin number, 1234. Just key that in and get into the system. And the software I'm using is called OBS Studio. Right, you see that? Cool. There's a checklist on the desktop. So you open that, it will show you what you need to check out for, right? First of all, we check the audio recording. Make sure that the audio levels are okay. So what you do is you right click on audio and select recording devices and make sure that blue icicle, the blue icicle, that guy is set as the default. So to find out whether it's actually getting sound, someone has to go and kind of scratch the grill a little bit and kind of like reach into the foam, kind of scratch the grill. Yep, you can see that the levels are going up and down. Yep, that means it's actually receiving sound from that system.
Okay, cool.
All right, So let's just update this because I was using a different sound card before. So blue bicycle, right? Yeah. So the second thing to do is start OBS Studio. Okay, so basically you double click on OBS Studio and it'll open up the recording. Yep, this guy. So again, you see this green bar going on there? That is actually the audio level of the microphone. So you have to check the audio level as well. Make it hover around 50 to 70%. It's kind of like the right range.
So the way we make it hover is we drag this bar, because it's like the game, is it?
Yeah, the game.
Okay, that's the sensitivity. Makes,
yeah.
So if somebody was standing there and they've got a really low voice, then you're going to drag that down to keep it at like the 50 to 70.
You can.
Good.
Okay. Yeah.
So like if I was right here.
So that's it. Oops.
Yeah.
Well, we just lost our signal, Bose. What did you do?
I didn't do anything.
Dude.
It's that beautiful voice.
Yeah. Let's check that again.
This is good. This is like real debugging. Yeah, look. It looks like it's lost the signal computer.
Huh.
Is Icicle still plugged in?
Yeah.
Okay. We are unplugging and replugging in the Icicle connector.
Ooh, what's going on?
This is when the ransomware pops up on the screen.
Okay.
Where did this laptop come from?
This was Bjorn's old laptop.
I was going to say, I thought it was Bjorn's.
Mm-hmm. What's going on?
ISO scan.
Yeah. Why is it doing that? That's weird. Ah, Windows. Anyway, I've been trying to reboot. Oh, is it trying to look for the driver?
What the hell? It's trying to install a driver.
What? I thought I installed yesterday.
Damn. I thought you had it working.
Yeah, it was. So
yeah,
weird.
But that was yesterday.
You did it right in front of our eyes.
I know. Never mind, let's try and reboot it.
It's good. All this debugging trick in the book.
Can we turn it off and on again? Okay, let's try that again. It's working properly right now. It's true. Wait, yeah. Don't do this to me, man. Come on.
No, it's actually, I'm happy that a problem presents itself.
Yeah.
So we resolve it. Oh, yeah.
Let's we'll go to sleep.
Yep.
I didn't check that right.
1, 2, 3, 4.
3, 4.
Yep. It's still there. The Chromecast right now. We could switch the source to change it to the
spiller.
Yeah.
Recording device.
And it's not showing the blue icon.
Oh wow, okay. That is not good. Let's check the connection here.
Same USB cable we used yesterday?
Yep. Same USB cable.
There you go.
There it is. So weird.
Okay.
Anyways, up and running, and hopefully nothing else goes wrong. So we start again, OBS. Yeah. That's 1, 2, 2. Okay, you get it. Okay. Right, so yeah. So right now, if I switch to picture in picture, I should see my screen.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever I have on my screen right now,
because you've got that going through the AirPlay.
Yep, it's going through AirPlay, and the webcam's coming in.
Yeah.
So you see a picture in picture.
And we see this Engineers SG like template with these two screens because you already made that in OSP.
Yes, got OBS, it. Yes.
OBS, sorry. So we don't have to do anything except pick the source or the template model we want.
So let's introduce the introduction to OBS. So what you see at the top is the exact screen that will be recorded. On the left are the pre-configured scenes. So the different scenes has different arrangements of the video sources.
Nice.
So on the right, you see the different sources that are over there.
Mm-hmm.
So you can splash screen, usually we'll start with this, picture in picture.
And they're all named.
Yeah, they're all named picture in picture 2, which has different size of both the screens. So in this case where the words on his presentation slides are big enough,
you switch to this so that you can see more of him talking. But if his words are really small, then you might want to just switch to this circle.
Yeah.
Or if it's super small, you just go straight to full screen, the only screen. And you can have a screen with video, which is kind of like an overlay. So,
And so this is something like basically you have to do, you're driving this while someone's giving the talk.
Yes.
Making the call as the director about what to show next.
Yes, okay. That's great.
You can't do it after the fact.
No.
Okay. So because it is actually recording this final bit stream as you're composing.
Yes, that's correct.
You could do it after the fact if you're recording the stream. So
right.
Yeah.
But this is easier, and it's less work to just do it live than to like post-process it all later.
Right.
Scenes, can you customize? Can you have your own scenes?
You can have your own scenes. You can create like a new scene if you want to, and then add the videos.
Yeah. So that's the ratio scene for the webcam that's a little less squished.
Okay, so right now I've set it up to crop the sides.
Okay.
So with the different scenes, with different sources, like right now the webcam, I've actually added a filter. So you right click on it, add filter. There's a crop filter that kind of like clips off the side. Okay. Right.
So the aspect is fine, it's just the crop.
Yeah, aspect is fine, just that I'm clipping the side so that I have a square video for this.
Cool.
Okay, some of the more common things that happen is when the presenter switches resolutions on their screen, or they change, or something happens to the screen capture, it might freeze. This thing might freeze to the first slide or second slide or whichever it is. So if that ever happens, you just double click on screen capture, click on deactivate, and activate again. That should kind of like jumpstart or reboot the video stream. So that's one of the more common things.
You're watching this screen during the process, and if you see this freeze when you don't expect it to, you quickly go and rejigger it.
Yes. And in this particular mode right now, so like say for the video, screen with video, say he has presenting stuff on the left side of the screen, you could go in and drag this to the right in real time. So you can kind of like, but just
when you let go that it changes, or is it actually seeing the whole drag?
Right? You're seeing the whole dragging, which is, but there's also a way around that, which I'll show you next. The next thing is, so you have the scenes, you have the sources, which are the video sources that are coming in. The mixer, which basically tells you what are the audio levels. There's also a fade scene transition, so you can set up like fade transitions and all that. Usually you don't need to touch this. So that happens when you click on the different scenes.
There's
a crossfade. In the past, it was just a cut over, which is kind of distracting, but now it's a nice fade. The next few buttons on the right are basically you can start a video stream if you want to stream to YouTube. But the more important button for you guys is the recording screen. So you click this, you start the recording. Right? So I can pretend to start recording now. Testing 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so you probably will hear my voice later. So then you can start switching to different scenes as and when it's appropriate. Another thing you can try, the last thing is the studio mode. Studio mode gives you a split screen like this. So on the right is the actual thing you're recording. On the left is actually a staging area. So you can pick up the next scene, like say I'm going to switch to this, but this is kind of placed in the wrong area. So I can drag this over to the left side first, and then click on transition.
Got it.
And then it brings over to the right thing.
That's really nice.
Yeah, this is a new feature that we released recently. So it's kind of, you just got to make sure to remember to click transition over, otherwise you won't be recording it. Yeah. Yeah, so by default, it starts in this. You can start in this mode, or you can start in this mode. But usually, I'll call this studio mode expert mode. So if you're not familiar with this, I think it's best to switch to this. Keep this mode. Settings will be where you can find all the other settings here. But it's all kind of configured in the way that it's kind of optimum for this machine. So you shouldn't have to.
I guess it doesn't have scripting, does it? You can write plugins.
But you can write plugins, I'm not sure. No, it doesn't.
So you can use auto hotkey to do some of these things.
Oh, yeah. It does have a key, it does have like keyboard hotkeys you can set up if you want to.
Sure. But you can use Windows auto hotkey to script a bunch of actions.
You could if you want to.
So you can have something that jogged the USB signal.
Right. So once you're done, you'll stop recording and the files should appear, like you click on file, view recordings, you should be able to see the video recordings from just now. So just now, the one that we shot should be this one.
Cool.
Yeah. Yeah?
Should we hear the sound that you record?
Hmm.
How many
of the devices
are
outputting to? Wait, I could be wrong signal somewhere. Playback.
There's only one.
Okay.
Not the camera. See the bag.
Okay, it's not really up. That's weird. Yeah, it's something. It's sometimes it's the wrong with this audio. The playback here. One way to check is to actually copy it out.
You think it's probably okay?
It's probably okay. I think it's probably just the laptop.
Do you want me to put on the NAS and check?
You could.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. Pistols. Pistols.
It's pretty good.
Come on, no one
recognizes
the movie
quote.
I'll never be appreciated.
Map a network drive. Z.
For SMB shares, can't I just do NAS.local?
You can.
Oh, and not .local, because that's a Mac thing, the zero call. Let's see if it'll... the only one I think it sees here is this. The NAS should show. Oh, wait, what network
are we on? The guest network.
That'll explain it.
Yeah. Well, anyway.
Let's just trust that the audio is probably recording okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, we can check it out later. Yeah, so...
And then when we're done, do we have to do any cleanup?
Shouldn't have to. Okay. We just need to copy it out, and then we should be able to... we should be able to use that.
Okay.
We can also try the media player. Let's see.
Yeah.
So...
Thanks for those. Cool.
Yeah? Okay, so the audio was captured quite okay. Yeah, so what you need to do next is just copy out the file and I can give you one of you guys access rights to the YouTube channel from Engineers.SG. You can upload straight away.
Awesome.
Or you can just send it to me and I can do a cleanup as well.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Questions?
Any questions? A few more other things. You won't actually need it here, but on that desk over there, you see a couple of adapters.
So in the case where you need to actually connect the computer to this, there is a VGA to HDMI adapter. So if you have a guest or presenter that only has a VGA output from this.
And it's also got an audio. If you wanted to capture the computer audio, but we're not set up for that.
No, but this one
is going to go out the HDMI.
Yeah, so this one does need to be powered. So if you're using if the presenter only has VGA, it needs to be plugged into the USB port.
Got it.
On his laptop.
Got it.
And you also have a mini display to HDMI, so it's for MacBook Airs, and a full display port to HDMI. This is for like older ThinkPads that only has full display port. But right now, here, I think most of you guys use a Mac, AirPlay, or do a Chromecast, that should be good enough.
Okay.
Right, so that's all that I have.
Any questions?
Cut! Videos, all the video stuff into the blue bag. And in other sets, we actually have an additional bag for the audio. But in this case, because it comes with a backpack, the audio pack can go into the front pocket. Right. So in the big backpack, the last pocket is meant for the laptop. So I can put that in first.
And so we can proceed to pack the video equipment.
So the video stuff, so most of the cables go to the topmost, the biggest pocket. The middle pocket is meant for like some more the more important cables that I use in this set. So the most important cable in this set right now is actually this guy. Because without this, you can't do any screen capture. So this for me is the most, from my perspective, is the most important cable. So I usually put that together here. Okay, so the rest of the cables like this, HDMI, this guy goes in.
So and the webcam too?
Webcam as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can go in the middle. So as you put the stuff there, there's a little
nice little pocket
hole in the middle. So yeah. That can also, I usually also put the splitter.
and the power supply. So this guy for the screen ever media, once you put the cables here, there's a kind of big pocket on the left. So that's usually where I stuff this. Mm-hmm. It's usually a nice little piece. It will fit quite snugly.
Would you put this in here or in there?
This is the cable. I can put it here as well. Okay. Yeah. What else is from this pack?
This is all much audio. Yeah. Okay.
So that's all we have for the video pack. Zip it up. So in cases where we're using the adapters, just remember to make sure the adapter cables are back in the front pocket as well. Yeah, so the front pocket is all the additional adapters. The three, there should be three in fact, right? So
cool.
What's in the middle pocket? There's actually also an additional HDMI cable inside, but it's still in this wrapping, so in case we need that in the future.
Audio, start with the heavy stuff.
Right, audio cable.
Anything that needs to be more protected, like that microphone maybe in the pocket? What do you think?
We can try, but it's a bit.
It doesn't look so deep, huh? Okay,
so we just put it in the corner and the rest of it.
Cool. Foam.
Okay, foam.
And this stuff?
And this stuff can go by the side.
Okay, right. And then the power cord should probably go in the back with the other.
Yeah, with the
Or in the electronics?
Electronics, right? Yeah. Right. And the
power board.
Power just goes right in. There should be the space there.
Cool.
And that's it. That's all you have.
Well, now it's in one convenience of steel.
Well,
package.
There's also the tripod. So the tripod will go back to the back. And it should be good enough.
Yeah, nice.
That's all. The blue icicle itself, this particular part of the set is kind of fragile.
It felt a little flimsy.
It felt a little flimsy, right? So, which is why be careful when you're removing the pin.
Yeah.
I may even advocate for keeping it plugged in to the other.
Yeah, that way there's less stress on that part.
Yes, there's less stress on that part. So I may.
I think that's a good idea. Because I was trying to be very gentle on plugging it, and it still felt like, ooh, this is a little bit.
Yeah, so I'll just keep this plugged in. That's good. This. I may even get like a duct tape or something just to make sure no one pulls it out. So, yeah, because we had one that was damaged because of that. So.
Good call.
Okay.
So that's it. Cool. Yay! Thank you, Michael.
Thank you.